Jesus is for. That one can come.
Amen.
Yeah? So thank you. Thank you. Lights, camera, action, that. As long as Jesus is at the centre, eh, guys? I'm really, 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 really blessed to be here today, to have got an opportunity to speak the words of God, to, you know, this is my family here. And even so emotional, you know, being back here. This is, I was at this church for about 10, maybe even 12 years. I honour Arthur, Liz, Paul, Mary, the family, and to meet all you new guys, my family as well. You see the church so busy, and the Spirit of the Lord is here.
Yeah.
You know, where the Spirit of the Lord is, there's freedom, yeah, there's liberty. And these songs declaring His goodness, declaring the year of the Lord as well. So, my name's Charles, and I love Jesus, you know. I'll tell, Arthur's asked me to do a wee bit of my testimony as I preach today. And I'll do that, I'll do a wee bit of my testimony, but I feel I've got a word for the Lord as well for us, guys. And it's for me, first and foremost, and I believe it's for yous as well. So, this church was good to me. This church was here for me through my darkest times. This Arthur and Linda was there with my wee baby. Gorgeous wee daughter, she had a lot of operations to go through. They were at the hospital, they were there for us. You know, the Spirit of God was here. You know, and I used to travel up, even when I never had a car, I would travel up to Irvine on the bus with the Wains. That was a trek, you know, pushing prams and everything. But somebody in the church blessed me with a wee car. You know, and God's provision's always been there for us. God is not a disappointment, people.
Amen.
He is not a disappointment.
Amen.
He will never ever let us down. He will never let us down. So, today, I'm back here again at my home church. God's moved me on in the ministry. I work for a charity called Broken Chains. The book of Isaiah says, they cried out to the Lord in their trouble, and the Lord helped them, and the Lord brought them out of their captivity, and He broke their chains in pieces. That's where the name Broken Chains came from. And we work with the most vulnerable of society. We work with drug addicts, we work with ladies of the night, we work with people that are really struggling, the elderly, the addicted, the afflicted, and everything like that. And we share the love of Jesus, we feed them, but we also see them recover. We also see them in the grace of God, and then they begin to become pillars in their communities. It's a beautiful thing. It's sweet and it's bitter because we see a lot of deaths and everything as well. So I'll get into the word, guys, and I'm so grateful that I loved the worship there. I was like, oh, I've really missed this. Oh God, this is amazing. I've not missed God because He's still been with me, but I've missed the fellowship with my family. You know, sweet is the fellowship of the saints. And to where the Spirit of God is, there's liberty. There's freedom in the house. There's freedom in here.
Yeah.
Praise God. So, if you want a title for my message today, it is, it's flipped and flopped a few times. I was asking God, I'll not go into the other ones, but the one that I felt the Lord to speak about today is, we are in a battle. We have to war a good warfare. We are in a battle, people. And we have to war a good warfare. So the message for the title is, fight the good fight. That's the message to the title. And I just want to start, you know, there's many battles. There's battles going on all over the place. You know, and we want to walk with the peace of God. We want to walk as children of God, in the presence of God, and in His will. So I'm going to go when Alan, thanks, Jean, that was a beautiful poem, wasn't it? Oh, it was beautiful, beautiful. Thank you, sister. Beautiful poem. When I lifted up, I will do an amen unto myself just to hear what He done for us and the prayers. And John, Alan was talking on the names of God, the names of Jesus. I love the names of Jesus.
Mm-hmm.
The enemy's got a few names, and all, by the way, deceiver, liar, and all that, right? And I'm going to speak a bit about Him today, but not glorify Him. I'm going to glorify Jesus. But what about this name? You never said it, I thought you might, but it's good that you never, because I'm going to use it. The Commander-in-Chief for the Lord's armies.
Amen.
The Commander-in-Chief for the Lord's armies. So when Joshua was in a battle, And God had delivered the children of Israel out of bondage, but he's delivered many of us out of bondage. Eh? Who's been in bondage for sin? And you've been set free for it. Amen. But God just doesn't want to deliver us. God wants to take us into the promised land. We don't want to stay in the wilderness for 40 years or longer. And what Joshua was doing, he was the understudy of the Moses' right-hand man who used to sit in the presence of God. He was called of God, Joshua and Caleb. And Moses was called of God as well. But what Joshua did, he was to take the land. And what he was doing, he was ready to go into Jericho. And when we're going to take the land, guys, we need instruction for the commander-in-chief of the Lord's army. And it says, before Israel was conquered Jericho, which was the first battle in the promised land, at this important moment occurred. Joshua surveying the city in close distance. So he's looking, what do we do here? How do we win for God? How do we take the land? And ours is spiritual land. No, for Israel it was the land, and that's good. We believe in Israel, and we believe that God will restore them. Arthur's big in that, and I love that too. But our land, our Scotland. And he was brainstorming and thinking of a plan. And as he glanced in the next direction, he saw an unexpected person standing next to him. And the man was frightened because he held a sword in his hand. That sword is the sword of the Spirit. That sword is the Lord. That sword is what we fight with, the sword of the Spirit. I'll read the scripture. And it came to pass when Joshua was in Jericho that he lifted up his eyes, and behold, a man stood opposite him with a sword drawn in his hand. And Joshua said to him, are you for us or for our adversities? Because it's a frightening thing to see a big angel with the Lord.
Amen.
It is. And he said, no, but as the commander of the Lord's army, and the Lord, I have come. The Lord has come. And Joshua fell on his face and worshipped and said, what does the Lord say to his servant? And the commander of the Lord's army said to Joshua, take the sandals off your foot, because the place where you stand is holy ground. And the Lord gave him this direction. And the Lord, in their days, what they done was he told them to praise in the walls of Jericho. Remember the wee song? Joshua took the battle of Jericho, and the walls came tumbling down. Through praise, when we praise God, when we give him praise, when we give him thanks, when we exalt him, when he instructs us. But this is a battle, guys. There was a battle in the physical, but there's a battle in the natural. I'm battling for souls. I'm battling for souls to see them. I'm seeing folk die left and centre. There's a boy here who's been struggling with stuff a lot of his years, and he came here and I testified a few weeks ago, and he asked Jesus into his life, and now God's restoring his life. Donald, his early days, but that's a battle for souls. And now, when I turned around this morning, his face was beaming like Moses, because the presence of God was here, and he's dancing to God and praising God. That's the battle I'm in, and the battle for our and your in, brother and sister, as well. So we're in a battle, but we obey God, and we praise, and we do the Lord's bidding. God wants us to take Scotland back.
Yeah.
I know it's big in Arthur's heart, and he sowed that into me, or God sowed that into me. I've got a heart for Scotland. I love Scotland. God loves Scotland, but for the land of the book, we became people that a lot of people don't want God, especially the establishment. But when you get out into the streets and you get, we were in the streets yesterday and we saw people come to Jesus, ask them into their life, preaching the word of God, sharing how good God is, declaring that he's real, declaring that he still loves Scotland, declaring that he's got a plan for Scotland, declaring salvation. That's the battle of the Lord. Not everybody's called to that, but every one of you are called to something. To share, to bring a wee kid up in the Lord. If you're a mother, you know, whatever he's calling you to, we're in a battle. Joshua was guided. And I'll pray for us, church, that we are, what did he say, what comes to your mind when you talk about Joshua? One thing I remember is, be strong and courageous.
Amen.
For the Lord your God is with you. That strength, that courage to do the will of God. It's sometimes hard to walk with God, isn't it? We have a lot of things are against him. Be strong and courageous, for the Lord your God is with you.
Glory.
And I want to declare today that God is able to give us this land. And we walk right there, and this is the, give me the land and I'll live whatever. John covered that, I'll live whatever way I want, I'll carry on sinning. God's grace is sufficient for us to be right with him and begin to walk with him. And he can give us land, whatever that, this land of Scotland back, your families, your wife, your grandchildren, your the people round about us, that's the land I believe he wants to touch. So now I'm going to go to another scripture. So that was just setting the tone for the battle. And guess what? Joshua won, didn't he? The walls came a-tumbling down. The walls came a-tumbling down. The walls came a-tumbling down. And the victory was given. And they never even out with swords that time. They'd listened to God and they went out with praise. Well, imagine hearing that sound. The praise was awesome in you. What would that have been like? Praise the Lord. The army of God marching. Come on. The enemy's like, what's happening? Who's out there? What's happening? Shh. The voice start coming down. Supernatural through praise to the king. Maybe the big angel that was here just went out of the wall. Bang. Done. That's my family, that's God's people, and I'm giving them the victory. When they obey me, I give them the victory. There's victory in Jesus, guys. There's victory for Scotland, for the Church of God. That a lot of this today has been for Israel, but I believe it's for the Church as well. God wants victory for the Church. He doesn't, I were weak, but he's strong. He's strong. We are weak, but he's strong. Joshua was weak, Elijah was weak. But in him, in their God, they became mighty in God for the tearing down of strongholds. And that's who we are, guys. If we'll catch a vision of who God is, and we get into it, I want to just share the day. This is a wee bit about the enemy as well, because we have got an enemy. Back then, the enemy was the Philistines and all the different ones that were there, the enemies of God. So now this is going into the book of Revelation. Revelation 12, verse 7, if you've got your Bibles. So what happened was, there was a war in heaven. So how do we have an enemy? Because there's a devil, right? So this is showing you a picture in heaven. I believe it's happened. Some it's happened, some it's already happened, some it's yet to happen, right? So a war broke out in heaven. Imagine this, big angels. Michael and his angels fought with the dragon. And the dragon and his angels fought. So this is a battle. Have you ever watched a film where you see the crazy battles? Imagine that this was like a battle in heaven and they did not prevail. Hallelujah. That's the devil and his angels. Nor was there any place found in heaven for them any longer. So the great dragon was cast down, the serpent of old called the devil and Satan, who deceives the whole world. Everybody deceives the whole world. That's who he is. He was cast down to earth and his angels were cast down with him. We're in a battle, guys. They're still around, but they're defeated because he was cast down. Jesus says to him, he didn't start shouting him, he spoke them up every time. And he said, I saw Lucifer fall from heaven like a star, shooting star. So there is a bit in here that's a warning. And it says further on that he's coming about and he's looking to accuse, he's looking to devour, steal, kill and destroy, that's his nature. But Jesus says, I see it, I see, I bury folk regular basis with drug addiction and it ravages them and they die and I see their wee mum and I see their family crying and I know the devil's got in. And I thank God that we also see the other side where Jesus rescues them and they get set free and they become responsible people and get their kids back and everything. Then I heard a loud voice saying in heaven, this is a good part of this wee scripture. Now, salvation and strength in the kingdom of God and the power of his Christ has come. Hallelujah. I'll go back to that. For the accuser of the brethren who accused them before our God, day and night has been cast down. That's how there's trouble in the world. Folks say, how is all this? There was time when God judged people, but we're under grace. It's the enemy that's upsetting the apple cart. He's trying to take him and his demons and his fallen angels are trying to take as many to hell as they can, because that's their destiny. But Jesus and his mighty angels and his mighty army and the church of God is trying to take as many as we can to heaven through the grace of God, through the mercy of Jesus Christ, through the blood of Jesus Christ, through the commander-in-chief of the Lord's army, through the Lamb that was slain, through the Lion of the tribe of Judah, through King Jesus, who is all authority in heaven and earth. This mighty angel could have been Jesus, right? The commander-in-chief, that's who he is. But we see him as a person. We see him as a man in the gospel. We see him in that wee poem, meek and mild, but also righteous anger, also full of love. You know what I mean? And also new, exalted in the heavens, but his spirit's here today. And his spirit's here to equip us. His spirit's here to fill us. So the accuser of the brethren's cast down, and it says later, he's bealing, he's raging, he's going about like a roaring lion, and he's also coming as an angel of light. So make sure what's getting said lines up with the word of God, people, in these last days. Mm-hmm. And they, sorry for shouting, get excited. Amen. And we can be clearly shouting at the Ranger Celtic game today. And I'm not saying but side them on, but I'd rather be in the church. God has to come first. God has to come first. We can have a wee light to a certain team, but Jesus has to come first.
Yeah. Yeah, appreciate
that. And they overcame him. They, yous, every single one of us, they overcame him by the blood of the Lamb and by the word of their testimony. By the blood of the Lamb. That's right back to the sacrifice. Now that angel was ready to back them up, and they were out singing and dancing, and I welcomed them, and there was a victory. We've got Jesus backing us up. He's the commander-in-chief of the Lord's army. He's the one that could have called down the angels but died because he loves us. He's the one that has all power in heaven and earth. He's the one that can walk through walls and appear. I remember wee Lucas, my wee son, he couldn't come because it was in the room. I remember we read that when he was a wee boy, and he, you know, he was like magicians and all that. He says, Jesus is magic, Dad. Jesus is magic. I says, yes, he's all power, son. He's got the most power and better than any magician.
Amen.
And it says they overcome by the blood of the Lamb, by his victory. We don't overcome in our own strength. We overcome by the blood of the Lamb, through Jesus' death. That's how I'm free from sin. That's how, when I was a maniac, involved in all sorts of stuff, deep dark violence and drug addiction and drug dealing, Jesus cleansed my heart and I was never ever the same. Never ever the same. Never ever the same. That old man died and somebody came alive. I still know all the people I knew. Still got the same tattoo. That's like the devil in my leg, your angel's devil. Reminds me still about. But Jesus comes into your heart, you're different. You're a different person. So they overcame by the blood of the Lamb and the word of their testimony, and the word of know their lives to death. That means they were willing to die what they wanted. Even some folk were killed for them. It's happening in Afghanistan and that they do. Therefore, rejoice, O heavens, for you who dwell in them. So it was great for heaven about the devil getting put out, wasn't it? It was great for heaven, but it's not great for earth, because he's down here trying to run amok. But guess what? Jesus never stayed in heaven and just left us. He came right down. He came down as a wee baby. He grew up as a tender shoot. He grew up sinless and probably got mocked and bullied for being a bastard. That's what they would have called him, wasn't he? He was the Son of the living God. He had a mother called Mary, who was a pure wee woman in Israel, who went through all sorts of trial to bring him into the world. They were persecuted and they had to run and hide. Thank God. Thank God he stayed faithful. Thank God even in the garden that he stayed faithful. When all his, but us, all his pals pray with me now. Has ever said to you pray with me now and you fell asleep? Mm-hmm. I have done, I'm getting better at it now. But you fall asleep when he tells you to pray. Yeah. Thank God he never came down, eh? Mm. I want to go back to that. And they overcame him by the blood of the Lamb and the word of their testimony. Let me go back to this before I get into that. Now salvation and strength in the kingdom of our God. The day, if you've no got it and you're no walking with God, you can have that. The free gift of God to set you free, for hurts, for hang-ups, for addictions, for afflictions, for anything you're struggling with. Salvation is getting to know. And also the power, and the power of our Christ have come. Who's grateful for that today? for the power of Christ has come. Yes. Amen.
Amen.
And they overcame him, the enemy. There's one thing about Jesus, it says he came to defeat the works of the enemy, and he did. I'm so grateful for that.
Yes.
They overcame him by the blood of the Lamb and by the word of their testimony. And they got a testimony in here. And they touched by the Spirit of God. And they know about freedom who's been in darkness. We overcome by that. But he wants us to move into deeper realms in God. He doesn't want to just keep us and say, I used to be that. He wants us to be like him. He wants us to move into the promised land and see people touched by the Spirit of God. See their families restored. I'll tell a bit of my testimony. I won't let it take too long in it. So I was involved in drug addiction. I was abused when I was in care home when I was 14. Started going astray. And that was hard. The boys that were being abused told me it happened. I tried to do something to the guys and they got hold of me and all put a gun out. I was only 14, 15. I was dyslexic, that's how I was in the proof school. It wasn't just, I was dyslexic and I couldn't learn at the school. So they actually put me with a tutor, but she was gorgeous, so I just sat and drilled. I never learned that. 13 like that, never learned any. But they put me in care law and there was a bad stuff happened in there, right? And I hardened my heart. I said, Nate, effing, you'll never hurt me again. And I hardened it. I wasn't aware of it, but I did look back and I can see it now. So I went into, I took substances to make me feel better. You know, I don't blame all my addiction on that, but I was involved in violence, I was in prison, and I had many failed relationships. I was involved in quite a big affluent drug gang who run amok, and I mean run amok. You know, they try to keep heroin out for years, they ended up coming in, and, you know, I tried everything to get clean. I even got implants in because I took heroin later on. No, I had sometimes had a lot of money, I had cars, I had my own business, I had a printing business, I had £1,300 suits, but there was times when I had nothing. In fact, I spoke at a recovery meeting the other night there, and the lassie, they liked the message I shared, and after that, a girl came up and says, remember I used to work in Jeansters? Now, there was times when I had hundreds of thousands of pounds, but there was a day then I'd run out of drugs and I just run into the shop and took a rack of jeans out of the shop and run out. And there was times I was sitting in my own business, I was crazy. And she said to me, and the guy chased me, and I went to knock the guy out, and it was a guy that was at school with me, I felt terrible. He went, Charles, what are you doing? He was the manager. Big Scott, Caruth, and I was like, get out of here. So I was either up there with Rolex watches and all the gold and all the birds and all that. Call it the champagne lifestyle. It's all a sham and it leaves you in pain, you know. And I went to a psychiatrist. I've been to all the psychiatrists in Scotland nearly, but I couldn't help any of them. they couldn't fix me. They done quite good. They done as best they could. I went to drug-induced psychosis, you know, and I was in and out all different relationships. My wee mom was crying and looking at me, and you know, I used to think I was like Brad Pitt because I'd all the designer clothes and start to lose my teeth. And my mom said, Brad Pitt, you're merely armpits in the stadium. You just tell me, you know what I mean? You need to get clean, Charles, tears in her eyes, you know. But my wee sister died. I'll tell this and then I'll move on into preaching again, right? I'll just give you a feel. My wee sister died with taking crack cocaine. It broke my heart, honestly. Beautiful, what a dancer this. Yeah, I love to dance. I love to dance in the church now. That's for Jesus, but she was beautiful. And she lost her wee life. And I couldn't even cry at the funeral because of the hardness in my heart. I remember doing that trip. It was horrible. My wee boy was born, my oldest boy, Chaz. And I couldn't be the dad that I wanted to be. And I'll tell you, the enemy comes to steal, kill and destroy. But I have come that you might have life and have it. See, when you get to that stage where you can't love your wee boy, I love the boy, the Dale Bootwell. He grew up in this church and that. He's not what we love the new, but he's so respectful. If I put a testimony or a wee word up, he posts it on Facebook and says, if you need help, go to my dad and all that. He's dead respectful of me. And I couldn't look after him. So the enemy had stole from me, and I'd done many bad things myself, right? And I nearly died taking cocaine. And as I was dying, Now, I'd been to the BBs when I was a wee boy, while your anchor hope in the storms of life.
Yeah.
All that, I knew God was good. And that night in the house, I nearly died, and I cried out to God. All it was I didn't know the sinner's prayer, I knew the Lord's prayer, but I said, God, I give you a wish. And guess what? That was a brilliant prayer. I didn't know nothing, but I'll tell you, his wish that I would be free, his wish that I would meet him, his wish that I would recover, his wish that I would be filled with the Holy Ghost, his wish that I would go to this church and be run about after 30, 10 years or 12 years, whatever it is, his wish would that I would be here today. When he shared the word of God with you guys, his wish, his will, that's really what I prayed, and he came and he set me free, and
he's good.
I've walked with him for 17 years. I went back to the drug gang. I told them I was finished totally. They said, what are you going to do for money? I said, the Lord will provide for me. And he has. He's never ever let me down. My car outside there, £6,500 because I did the work of God. I couldn't afford a car. Somebody blessed me with it. My car when I was in here was blessed by me. No, my character changed. It changed my character. I used to growl at folk and all that, but now I want to help them. Now I want to help them. I've seen bundles of people get well, and now I'm seeing friends get well as well. You know, on the street the other day, yesterday, the guy was meant to come this morning. I took a funeral of one of my friends who'd been involved in a lot of crime, and he died. I took the funeral, and when I took the eulogy, a girl said she needed to get recovered for drugs. She got saved that night on my recovery Jesus Centre recovery meeting. She's now 4 months sober and clean. And she's on fire. She's now working at Broken Chains as a volunteer. Donald's been running about her as well. And she brought a guy to the streets when we were preaching in the streets. And an ex of hers. And he asked Jesus into his life as well. He was going to come today, but they never made it. But he's still saying he's definitely got to go to a local church next week. That's God. That's God, guys. That's God. So I just want to see how good he is, you know. He taught me how to read. I couldn't read, and he taught me how to read. I said, God, if I can't read, how am I going to share your work with people? And then I started reading these scriptures like, I can do all things through Christ who strengthens me, right? And I put even scriptures up on my door. He has delivered me from the power of darkness, because I was in a gang. They were priming me to run. They were wanting me to run all the drugs. It was millions of a lot of money. They all get 12 years and all that. But God was saying, no, you're working for me. I'm going to train you to work for me, Charles. You're a man of God. My name is Charles Savage. I own my birth certificate with Kingsman. And I'd used the two names be going out the country and be on the run for the police. And God says, no, you need to choose one name, because when I made amends, they said that. So my name's Charles Savage, Kingsman. I use that name because I'm the King's man.
Amen.
God never gave me that name for nothing. I offended my mum, and I didn't mean it, but I feel God gave me it because I want to be his man. I'm no longer, nothing rang with the name Savage, but I was like a savage. But now I'm his. And now I belong to him, and now I want to do his work as well. So much more, I had hepatitis, and the Lord healed me for it. Wow. And he's kept me. I've seen bundles of people come to Jesus. See, I lost my wee sister. My wee sister got 13 years, my other sister, I've got two sisters. Be careful what you pray for. I'm praying, God, she wasn't a bad man. I didn't know she'd been involved, but we were heavy in her. And she ended up getting 13 years, she got to jail, and I'm praying, God, what's happening here? And the next thing, God gave me a promise. He says, my ways are higher than yours. My ways are not your ways. As the heavens are higher than the earth, so are my ways higher than yours. And as the rain comes down, feeds the plants, it gives seed for the sower, so will my word not return to me void. And I'm like, what does that mean? Can she not get cut down a wee bit for 5 years? She hardly had done that. She could have done me a text. Because she thought she was high as we were a lot of years ago. Anyway, I'm not getting into politics there. God gave me a promise. So see if you've got promises for God, guys. Hang on to them. Cling on to them. Pray into them. Because we're in a battle for souls. Keep on the promises of God. I kept on that promise. I visited her. I loved her. And guess what? She's out 6 months' time. She's done the full 13 years, 6.5 years she's done. Saved a year and a half ago. Saved by the grace of God. Saved by Jesus. And she's got a wee recovery Bible in there. She's reading it every day. She phones up and she talks to me. And then she's like, I never got a chance to talk about Jesus enough, so I'll phone you back just to talk about the Lord. I seen her last week. Like, Jenny's crying because that's my dear wife. I got a great wife, Jennifer. After married this, I love that wee woman. I'm her. I mean, she calms me down. I've got beautiful wee children that are blessed and bringing them up in the Lord. And I'm so blessed. I'm too blessed to be stressed. Too blessed to be stressed. The other guy says, I'm too anointed to be disappointed. But God is good, guys. God is good. God is good. And he's no respecter of persons. It's no, oh, Charles, I do believe it. There's certain, some to be prophets, some to be evangelists, and some to be, you know, for the equipping, the church. That's right. That everyone is. God has got a plan for you. And no matter where you are, if you're struggling today, he's definitely got a plan for you. Don't believe the lie that he's not. As well, so that's what I wanted to. They overcame. That's a testimony, but I want to be an overcomer. That testimony is good. I want to see my mate that I run about with. I could tell you some stories about me and him. But he came here the last time when Arthur invited me, and he's asked Jesus in these early days, pray for him, Donald his name is. He's got a wee lassie, right, and she's been through a bit. And that's what he wants today, sir, get well so that he can have that relationship and have his life restored. That's what God does. He's a God of restoration. So this is me. I'm going to go into the last bit of my word today. So it's the dry bones. Them bones. Remember that? They used to sing that in the school, didn't they? Now hear the word of the Lord. So I'm going to talk about the prophet Ezekiel. I'm kind of Old Testament today, but that's all right, because God's word is whole, isn't it? God's word is whole. God's grace comes through Jesus. The law came through Moses. But Jesus is the fulfillment of the law. So, one thing I want to flag up about Ezekiel. Ezekiel was a prophet. It was before Jeremiah, okay? So it was around about 571 BC, before Christ came. And he came to announce judgment on Israel and other nations and to foretell eternal salvation to God's people. That's where Ezekiel, in a wee short version, who he was. So even if you're an unachiever, an underachiever, is there any underachievers in here? You just feel you don't get where you want to be, there's hope. If you're a non-believer, even if you don't believe and you're not fully through for God, there is hope. Even if you're an overachiever, there's hope. Or maybe you're like Jacob and you're a deceiver, like I was. A couple of deceivers in the house. Remember? Charles Savage, Charles Kingsman. He changed my nature when I came to him. I'm no longer that. I'm not saying I'm perfect. That's Jenny, she knows I'm not. Right? But my nature's changed. I'm a child of the Most High. My man of God. And that's what he wants to do. If you're a deceiver, then you're in the right place. But God doesn't want to keep you there as well. And maybe you're a believer. Any believers in the house?
Yeah.
What about a receiver? Is there any receivers to receive the Holy Ghost today? Yes. To receive the Word of God today?
Yeah.
Believer and receiver.
Yes.
So these dry bones. So the first thing I just want to say about Ezekiel, he spoke about the new birth. This was all these years before even Jesus came. And it says, I will take you from among the nations. He's talking about Israel, but I'm using it for the new birth because it is gathered you out of all countries, and Israel is back in the land now, that's happening, and bring you into your own land. Then wait your last, then I will sprinkle clean water on you, and you shall be clean.
Yes.
Hallelujah. And I will cleanse you from all your filthiness and from all your idols, and I will give you a new heart. That's him prophesying the new birth. Ezekiel, all the years ago, he was a man that seen visions, he was a man that professed judgment in that, but he also gave great hope. And wait your list, and I will put my new spirit in you. That's beautiful. That's Old Testament. All the years before God came, he's putting a new spirit in us. Who wants that fresh touch to Jesus today? That new spirit. And I will take out, this is how I changed, guys. I meditated on this when I couldn't read. When I was still a maniac, I just came to Jesus. Changed my heart. I didn't know why I'd go and hurt people. I'd done great violence. I wept to it. I needed a new heart, guys. Religion's not going to do it. It has to be real. And I will take the heart of stone, that's what I had, out of your flesh, and I will give you a heart of flesh. Hallelujah. A new heart. And I will put my spirit within you, and I will cause you to walk in my statutes, and you will keep my judgments and do them. Who praises God for that?
Amen.
Old Testament, right? So now I'm going to speak about the dry bones. And then that's like, guys, the Spirit of God's amazing, isn't he? It says, the hand of the Lord was upon me. There's about 12 verses in this, so bear with me, guys. The hand of the Lord was upon me, and he brought me out in the Spirit of the Lord, and he sat me down in the midst of the valley full of bones. Then he caused me to pass by them all around, and behold, there was very, very many in the open valley, and indeed they were very dry. And he said to me, Son of man, can these bones live? And I wonder, when we look at Scotland, Israel, we believe, because it says Israel will be saved, but God so loved the world that he gave his one and only Son. I wonder, when we look at the church and we look at Scotland, can these bones live? When I see the people and I look into their eyes and they look dead, I want to prophesy life over them. I want to say you can be free. I want to speak life in them. I want to see the Spirit of God coming into their heart. Can these bones live? And I said, oh Lord, you know. And again he said to me, prophesy to these bones and say to them, oh dry bones, hear the word of the Lord. And I want to encourage you, church, prophesy and speak. Know what the spirit of prophecy is? The testimony of Jesus. The testimony of Jesus is the spirit of prophecy, it says in Revelation. Thus says the Lord God to these bones, surely I will breathe, cause breath to enter into you, and you shall live. I will put shoons on you, sinews, that's the wee bits that the bones click. And on you I will bring flesh upon you, and cover you with skin, and put breath in you, and you shall live. Then you shall know that I am the Lord. Back to Adam. The breath of God is the Spirit of God. When God created the heavens and the earth, he wanted to make man in his own image, and he made, he sculpted Adam, and he breathed the ruach, the breath, the very breath of God came into him. That's how we're different from animals. He's a living soul, the breath of God. Jesus done it, he went, receive the Holy Ghost. Didn't he? Because he's God standing saying, receive the Holy Ghost. The breath of God comes into the army. We are the army of God. It's Israel, and we pray for them. We should weep for them. We should weep for everybody, every soul. But we are the army of God. We need the breath, the ruach. We need the spirit of the living God for us to march up, for us to rise up, for us to fulfill our destiny in God for Scotland and the ends of the earth. This is our Jerusalem. And you shall know that I am the Lord, the one that breathes life into a dead thing. Remember Lazarus? Lazarus, come forth. Boom, 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 with the bandages on. And the disciples had to take them off him. Sometimes we have to do that. That's what we found, they're still broken, even though they've asked God in. So I prophesied as I was commanded. And as I prophesied, there was a noise. And suddenly a rattling, and the bones came together, bone upon bone. Indeed, as I looked, the sinews and the flesh came upon them, and the skin covered them over. But there was no breath in them. And I see that sometimes when folk are coming to God, God works in them before they come to God. I don't know if it happened to you. You start thinking, I know what happened to me after. He was thinking, there's something there here. Guy gave him a track. But before he actually had the Spirit of God, there was something happening in him. Yeah. There was something happening. The Holy Ghost goes before. John spoke about it. The Holy Ghost goes before. And there's something happening. That's when we pray into it. That's when we begin to prophesy over people. That's when we speak and pray. I've seen my wee sister. That's one salvation that I'm grateful for. I'm grateful for every one of them, but imagine that wee lassie go out and get another 15 years, that wee life would be wrecked. Imagine she go out and die with my other wee sister. Guess what? She's good news, she's going to praise the Lord. Good news, she's going to serve Jesus, because I prayed, God put it in my heart to prophesy, prophesy, son of man. He's worked, Lord, because I want to see your kingdom. The angels are warm in heaven. We have to war on our knees for souls. We have to fight the good fight with all of our might. We have to get our rain vessels clean and walk. We are walking righteousness sin. He said it this morning. Turn away from that, guys. I'm not here to lambast you about that. But how better it is when we feel the Spirit of God when we've been obedient. Amen. Under grace, thank you, Lord. I'm turning away from that. It's no good. Hallelujah. I feel your presence. Covered them, and there was no breath in them. And he said, prophesy to the breath, prophesy, son of man, and say to the breath, thus says the Lord, this, This says the Lord God, come, O four winds, and breathe on these slain that they may live. Have you ever seen somebody walking with God and then they fell away? I've prayed many times for people that they would come back. So I prophesied as he commanded me, and breath came into them and they lived. And they stood up and they had a great exceeding army. What does it say? An exceedingly great army. So when we have this spirit, this ruach of God, and we are prophesying life, when you see a brother fall down, we're not meant to kick them.
No.
You can challenge them, lift them up. Come on, brother. Let's pray about this. Come on, back. We love you. We need to lift each other up. Remember the two wee boys that were running, one in a field, and he could have won the race. The two twins, I think it was.
Yeah.
He didn't run on the race, he come back, he helped his wee bro.
Yeah.
And he didn't lose the race, but he actually won in my estimation. Because
yeah.
He lifted his brother up. We need to encourage each other in this race, in this fight, the good fight. We need to say, come on, brother, you fell. That's not the end of the story. Because God's glory can touch you. See, when you mess up, come away then, get back in the fight, get back in the race. Because God is, and we've to prophesy into these dead bones, we've to prophesy into these places, and they lived and stood up on their feet. That's the army of God now standing. And I can feel it in my spirit. I'm not going to take that we're going to remain the drug death capital of the world. We're in Europe. That's how we're seeing people set free. That's how we're going with what we've got. Do you know what I mean? That's how I need to, every one of us will get that wherever we are, to do the work of God. An exceedingly great army. Then he said, Son of Man, these are the bones of the house of Israel. Indeed, they say the bones are dry. Our hope is lost. I wonder if you've ever felt that. You've ever felt hope's lost. You've ever felt I've messed up. That's it. Life's hard, by the way. And not everybody gets healed. Somebody's gone through some deep stuff. I took a funeral a couple of weeks ago. A wee boy died of cancer, 20-year-old. And I'm taking the funeral. Only God could help me. It's easy to blame God at that stage, innit? But God gave me words that I could encourage the family. Encouraged them, and it was my wee boy Charles that I prayed for. It was his best friend. Who could, you know, I told you what I was like. How could I ever have stood up at a funeral with 300-400 folk there and say that God's good? This wasn't God that's done this to this young boy. Because when Jesus was here, he healed people, he set them free and stuff like that as well. I will open your graves and cause you to become up from the graves. See, when Jesus, I'm going to finish, I've not got long. When Jesus died. You spoke about it, Jean. When he died, see when he was raised to the dead. I don't know how it's not preached all the time. The holy men of the city come out of their graves and went in. That's what the Bible says. This has happened. But I believe there's graves, there's stuff in our lives that God wants to bring us out of, to be the army of God. Eh? Is there things in our lives that God needs to free us from? Is there more in God? Is there an army rising up? Because they can go to the army, there's hundreds of wars to know, but there's wars in the spiritual, and there's wars for us, and we need the commander-in-chief. We need King Jesus to equip us, to fill us, to encourage each other to go in this. We need to prophesy, we need to speak life into each other, and we need to challenge each other as well.
Mm.
Who knows, we need a challenge. We need to put up the hooky noon again. Brought you up from the graves. Who's ever been brought up to a grave? I have. A mighty clay, a pit, is set my feet upon a rock.
Mm.
I will put my spirit in you. There's a promise. See, if you don't know the Spirit of God, he will put his spirit in you, and you shall live.
Wow.
You shall live. I've seen many folk die, but I've also been asked to be best men at weddings, of boys that were nearly dead, and now they're marrying lovely Christian lasses, and their weddings are all there. Mm. And you're sitting going, folks, you're amazing. I could take you to them, I could bring them and they could testify to that.
Mm.
And then they're working for God and they're lay preaching and, oh, you're like, that was somebody that could have died, God. But you said, speak life into them, prophesy, and then it's all out to you. I encourage each other and he encourages me a lot as well now. That's awesome. And I will place you in your own land. And that is Israel, but it's also us. He's placed us here. He's got a heart for Scotland, I've got a heart for Scotland. You've got a heart for Scotland, but have we got a heart for him? Have we got a heart for his spirit?
Mm.
Then you shall know that I, the Lord, have spoken it and performed it, says the Lord.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
I just want to think about the promise that he gave me for my wee sister. What promises has he gave you? Guys, the promises of God are yes and amen. And I'm standing with you for the promises, but I do believe that we need an outpouring of God's Spirit. We need to prophesy to the four winds and say, God, even today, God, come and touch your church in his gate. We love you, God. We love you, but we need you, oh God. Please come and give us a fresh touch. You need a fresh touch. Because it's no easy, you know, the climate's changing and they're saying this is right and sin's wrong and sin's right and the goodness of God's wrong. In some areas we need the Spirit of God. So that's what I want to say today, that's what I want to pray today, that we get that fresh touch to God. I'm going to ask you today, if there's anybody here that they feel that they've been in that dead place, that place where you've just been struggling a wee bit with the dry bones, where you just feel you're not getting on. Can I ask you to stand up if that's you? You feel you're in a bit of a place where you feel dry. You've maybe been with God and you've slipped away. He loves you. He absolutely adores you. And the breath of God can touch you today. And I pray, just ask him to fill you. Let's just you shout out. I'm not going to even tell you who we say. But I say, come to the four winds. Come, Holy Spirit. The breath of God is the Ruach. It's the Holy Ghost. And I pray, I'll say a prayer and I want you to cry out to him. God, I just pray for my brothers and sisters. I speak to the four winds. I speak to the heavens and I pray, God, mighty army of God, Holy Ghost, come and touch my brothers and sisters. Fill them with the Holy Ghost. Even baptize them afresh with Holy Ghost fire. And you just cry out to him, guys. You just cry out to him. Spirit of God, you're welcome here. Speak out and just ask him to come into your life afresh. He is able to do exceedingly abundantly above anything we ask. Oh, thank you, Father. 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 You're worthy. You're worthy, King Jesus. And can I ask for the second people, see anybody who feels they've maybe not connected and you want a prayer, I'm happy to pray with any, so is Arthur, right? But can I ask for the army of God? If you want to be in the army of God and you want to stand and say, God, I want you for a good warfare as well, please stand as well and say, God, please come into my life afresh. And that, I'll just say a prayer, okay? Thank you, Jesus. Just stand if you're wanting to be in God's army and say, this is me, I'm declaring. If you confess me before men, I will confess you before my Father. And see if you're more comfortable standing, lift your hands. But if you can't stand for him today, I'll be hard for you to stand for him when you're going through some stuff. But even raise your hands and just ask him. I just want to say a prayer. God, I thank you that your army is mighty. And I thank you for the testimonies in here and the love that these people have for you. And I thank you that you have a plan for each and every single one of them. God, and I pray to the four winds, I pray to the Holy Spirit, I pray to you, King Jesus, that you will touch each one of them here and you will show them how to fight the good fight. You will help them win people, you will help them be free, you will help them, Lord, in the battle that you have already won. Hallelujah, Lord. Hallelujah. Paul, do you want to play something, brother? The battle that we've already won.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, Lord Jesus.
Thank you.
Lifting our hands to you.
So we'll just worship the Lord and just give him praise. I must be easy. He must sing these guys. And if anybody wants prayer, just come out the front. I'm happy to pray for you also. Thank you.
All you do as we pray.